Hey guys, welcome back to another video here. It's Dr. Crypto, and in this video, I want to talk about the Cronos, and I want to talk about crypto in general, because at the moment, we've just had a bit of a pullback yesterday, and I've seen a little bit of panic set in because of this little pullback. And I say in every video, you know, we're going to get pullbacks. When we're in the bull market, it's not just all pure green. We will get those pullbacks. But before I start, smash that like button and give a subscribe. You know, it doesn't cost you anything to hit though that thumb up and that subscribe button. Your support is always much appreciated. So like I said, nothing on here is financial advice. Do your own research. That's what I say, and have a plan. But at the moment, we can see on the hourly, it is green, especially from yesterday. It was a bit of a red day yesterday. But it looks like we're starting to recover a little bit. We can see, yeah, MOG's up 1.4, PIF is up 1.6, HBAR 1. You know, and it's climbing. We are holding strong. I think the bulls are holding strong. And we can see it's a bit of a mix, but it is recovering. Beam up 4.4. SPX 2.2. MOG is up 3.1. And GOAT is up 24.9. We can see on the weekly, we're still on the up. Hex is slightly down by 25%, but that has made some big moves, to be honest with you. On the month, you know, things are still up. And on the yearly as well, it's looking all good and hunky-dory. But what I want to talk about today is Cronos, because CRO is just going sideways. And I know it's making a lot of people, yeah, a bit, not worried, but getting a bit fed up, because we see these other coins start popping off. We want to see Cronos starting to make big moves because, you know, at the end of the day, we see crypto.com with all the advertisements and they're doing well on their spot trading and institutional trade. You know, they're doing really, really well on that. And the Cronos ecosystem does get traction, but I think it's just falling a little bit flat at the moment. But I think that, you know, when retail do come back, I think we're going to get some moves. But you've got to look back in early this year when we saw Core got listed on crypto.com. Wow, that pumped and that gave a bit of ignition and lit the fuel for the Cronos ecosystem. And since then, I think it's fallen a little bit flat. And I think like with at the moment, when you look at Core, it's got like organic growth. It's got a big following. It's got a strong community there. And I think this is what we need with Mary. And I'll get into this because Ken here, who sort of heads up the Cronos chain ecosystem, and he mentioned, and now I like the Croge community and I like Croge. I don't hold any Croge at all. You know, I've told you, I hold Mary, Core, and Ryoshi, and Krob as well. And he goes here, the announcement about the reactivation of the Croge coin project made me want to look recently user activity on the Cronos EVM chain. Interested to see the Cronos EVM chain shows signs of renewed momentum in terms of meme project activity. Now, I think what will happen is it's like I said, when we saw Craw get listed on crypto.com, that did ignite the Cronos chain that little bit more. And I think we need to I personally think, and put me wrong in the comments below, but I really do think crypto.com needs to list Merry. And I think if Merry gets listed on the crypto.com app or the exchange, it's going to reignite a new momentum into the Cronos chain, because we could see there's a lot of people that are in a community or who own probably Core as well are also holding Merry as well, and you want to see Merry get listed. It's on Merry is listed on MEXC. Why is it not listed on crypto.com? I don't understand it. And I think though, obviously Ken and Chris from crypto.com must meet up now and again to have their monthly or quarterly meetings about the Cronos chain and crypto.com. I really hope that they will, on the 31st of October, will list Merry. Because I think if Merry gets listed on the crypto.com app, I think it will send a new ignition into the Cronos chain and get it moving forward again, like I said. And because we see Core making moves, it still makes moves to the upside. It's got a big community, Core has. And I think Merry has also got that momentum behind it as well in terms of the community. It just needs listing on crypto.com. And I think for the Crow fam, I think that's what they should do. They should list it because it's going to bring new people into the Cronos chain as well. And I'm under all support about the Croge. But I want to see Merry listed because we already know that has got momentum behind it. It's just, it's like in a bubble at the moment, Merry is. And it's just waiting for that bubble to blow to get Merry released into the atmosphere, to let it all spread its wings and get out there and do what it needs to do and get that community growing even more. But that's my own personal opinion on it, because we can see here Core is up at the moment at 32 million and we know Merry is sitting at around about that 11.2 million. Now, I personally think, could it get up to the what Core is at the moment? Yes, I do. I personally think that because I think it's got Merry has a strong community behind it already. But I think that community will grow even more when it come when people can actually buy it on the crypto.com app. And if Merry gets listed on that, we can see at the moment we had that big push up, downward, flatwards, sideways action. This is accumulation range, in my opinion. And we've broken out of that wedge. Now, if we get this on crypto.com, I'm expecting a big move like what we had right here early in the year in April. I think we're going to get that again. So that's why I've been DCAing into Merry. And I really, really do hope that Ken takes this on board. They must know about this because they must see that people keep on tweeting about Merry and, you know, doing videos about Merry. And I really do think it's daft. It's silly not to list it on the crypto.com app. They give little hints now and again on crypto.com regarding Merry, but it's not listed. And I really do think, and I'm hoping, like I just said previous in the video, that I'm hoping the 31st of October is the time to get listed. I'll be really, really, be honest with you, gutted if it's not listed on the 31st of October or before. That's my personal view of it. I am a Merry holder. I do hold a lot of Merry. And of course, I want the price to go up. But also, I think it'll be good for the Cronos project as well, which in turn will help CRO coin as well. Because look what happened with Core when it's got listed. Absolutely a gigantic candle. We've come down slightly and look, we've had another big candle. The volume is becoming, is coming there in terms of Core because the community is an organic community and it's building all the time. And there's more and more people joining the Core community. And I think that's what's going to happen with Merry. You only have to go for Core. You only have to go on X to see what is going on. There's a big community out there. And I really do think the same for Merry. And again, you just have to check X for Merry. You can see it here. Merry, it's just such a big community. And you can see here, people want it listed on crypto.com. Dear crypto.com and Cronos Chain, you have an amazing opportunity on this up-and-coming Halloween to create something unique and special, which has never been done before. Don't waste it. And that's my worry. I don't want them to waste it. I want them to list Merry, and I think it's going to be good for crypto.com and it's going to be good for the Cronos chain as well, because the community, just like Core, is a big community and I think it will grow. But overall, I think it's going to have an impact on CRO, my personal view, because at the moment we've just been dropping downwards at the moment and just chopping sideways. We're just in this range between that 8 cents and 7.5 cents at the moment. That's the range we're in. Now, I think if Merry gets listed, that's going to bring new momentum into the CRO coin as well. That's what I'm personally thinking. Like the Cronos chain will gather momentum and in turn, it will have some point have an effect on the Crow coin. At the moment, Crow coin's just been chopping sideways. We're going up, chopping sideways. I don't want us to drop down here below the wedge. I don't want us to come down to 7 cents. I want us to hold where we are and gradually make our way up to the upside. That's what I'm hoping. I'm waiting for alt season. I'm always buying CRO because obviously I've got the debit card and I do the earn and I do the DeFi as well. So I've got it staked. So I'm always earning CRO. I'm always DCAing it every day with that one. But hopefully that we'll get this momentum in the Cronos chain. And I really do. And I think it's good. It would be good for the Crow fam as well. It will bring new enthusiasm, motivation into the Crow fam. There's a lot of people in the Crow fam. And a lot of people are just waiting for this big moment for Merry to get listed. I really do hope it is the case. But as well, going on to like the general crypto market, we saw yesterday we had Bitcoin that pulled back a little bit. Yesterday we came, you know, we came all the way back down here, down to about that $65,000 mark. And, you know, why people are panic selling people are panic selling, and just like Wall Street Bets puts here, pussy index, extreme pussy, it's like at 20. We got like what Crypto Rover tweeted here yesterday. This man bought $317 million worth of Bitcoin, dollars worth of Bitcoin. Why you were panicking? And why retail panic? And I keep saying this, the institutions, the whales are accumulating. They don't care about these little dips. And I don't really care about these little dips at all. To me personally, if I've got cash on the side, for me, is a decent opportunity. These dips in the bull market, when the bull market, when you get big dips, it's DCAing opportunity, in my opinion. You know, it really is. And I think like, and that's the problem with retail. The slightest movement, they start panicking. And then you start seeing sentiment change on X. People start becoming a little bit more salty, a bit more it's a scam and everything else. But then we move up. In every bull market, it's not just green candles. We do get red candles, quite significant red candles as well, you know. But at the moment, we're just chopping around on the daily. We're just chopping around. But look on the week, if you zoom out on the weekly, it's like I said, always zoom out. You've got to zoom out because, like, you know, we've got, like I said, we've got this massive, if I could find it on here, if I do the path. You can see here, we've got this inverse head and shoulders, what's being formed. Right here, what's been formed. And I think, stop that there. Yeah, we've got that inverse head and shoulders, what's been formed. And I think like we've got also that cup and handle, which I said, we've got the cup here, we've got the handle. But also on the daily, we've got the bear bull flag, should I say, which is all imminent for breaking out. And we can see money flow is coming in still. It's not coming out, it's coming in. And this is where, this is what makes me long-term really, really bullish on Bitcoin and the crypto market in general, and especially like meme coins like Mary and Core, because they're all community-based, and I think that has a strong power behind it. But any of these dips, in my opinion, are DCAing dips. Always do your own research, you know, and nothing I say on here is financial advice. Always do your own research. That's what I say. But don't worry about, in my opinion, about these small dips. You're going to get them as we start making our way further up to the upside. Once we break that resistance around that $70,000 to $72,000 and we start pushing up, we're going to get big corrections on the way up. And it's going to feel like, are we going back into a bear market now? And this is where you've got to learn that strategy of take profits as we're going up, because nobody knows where the top is. And it's like in the bear market, when you DCA, nobody knows where the bottom is. It's a simple fact. And that's why I always say, as we're going up, always take profits. That's how I say, because like I said, if one day we crash down into a bear market, you'll be very happy that you took profits. That's my opinion. That's what I did in the previous bull market. And like I said, always have a plan as well. You know, so yeah, it's looking all good. Everything in my looking all bullish, in my opinion. So like I said, give us a like and give us a subscribe, and I'll see you soon in the next video. Take care.